1001 Nights, Part 4. This part, The Dog Brothers. Previously on 1001 Nights, Shahrazad continued her story with the king. She told the story of the first old man, which was the girl who turned into a deer. The story was about a couple who wished for a girl as their daughter. But they spoiled that little girl later. She was making troubles for her mom and dad. One day that she was expelled from school, her devastated mom got really mad and wished a weird wish. To change her daughter with a deer. And it came true. Because the Amen bird was accidentally there, to say a big Amen. The spoiled, jealous girl gone, after that wish. Actually, she was traded in for a deer. A pretty one. After that accident, the mother went crazy. And the father? He is now an old man with no normal family. A troublesome family, in fact. Even the monster got emotional for the first old man's story and let him free. The monster gave up eating him. The king fell asleep again. Shahrazad was happy about him falling asleep, since she would have another take at story therapy. And now, the rest of the story.
Hello, Master King. Let's continue our story. How are you today?
I am fine, Shahrazad. I am fine and so waiting for the rest of the story. So, did old man number one just leave?
In fact, no. He didn't just leave.
Thank you for your generosity, Mr. Monster. But you know, I feel, as a father for poor merchant, I cannot leave him here alone and frightened. Can I take him with me? I want at least one third of him, since I can see in these men's eyes that they feel the same for him. May I, Mr. Monster?
Although I hate the idea of sharing my food with others, but because I enjoyed your story, I would say yes. You may have one third of my merchant food.
Excuse me, Mr. Monster, I need to inform my friend to feed my brothers. They must be so hungry now. And when they are hungry, they get mad, destructive mad.
Hey, wait. Are your brothers monsters? Because we monsters turned into destructive things when we are hungry.
So, the old man number two shared his story as well.
I had triplet brothers, the same age and almost the same shape. But not the same attitudes. We were in our 20s and were fresh graduates from university.
Their father was a nice man. All of his life, working hard to earn a comfortable living for his family. After boys' graduation from university, he felt responsible for them. So he arranged a meeting with them, asking about their dreams and plans for their future. They all said they want to have their own small business. He was amazed to listen to them. As they said, their only problem to start their business plans was lacking enough money. The father was waiting for this moment.
I will provide the financing. But please be careful about how you spend it. This is all of my life saving.
One. Which is our old man number two, started a convenience store, as he had planned, but the other two sons forget about their vows to their father. They waste all their money on entertainment. Finally, their money finished. They had no saving and even not a coin to buy some food. They called their father, lied to him about a bankruptcy, asking for more finance. The father was devastated and sad, since he knew that they were lying. He had seen his son's photo on Facebook, having fun instead of working hard for their businesses. He got a heart attack after that conversation.
And my poor father died after a short while.
This is sad and so bad of you humans. You often act like monsters. Like dark monsters. Your poor dad.
But the first brother. Do you remember he had a convenience store? He was successful in his job, and he recently got married to the kindest girl in the world. She was so poor before they married. And, as you see, She was so ugly. But Arga loved her sweet great heart. Her face was not important to him at all. One day, after their father's death, the troublesome brothers came to the convenience store, asking for money. They claimed for a share in that store.
I was their brother, after all. We were triplets. I gave them some money, because I feel for them as my family. I forgave them for what they have done to our dad.
The evil brothers, after taking the money, made fun of his wife, telling her she is like an alligator. They broke her heart. And his heart as well. They broke into the store the other day, and stole everything. They beat their brother so hard too. He fainted. And they ran away. He was knocked out on the ground unconscious, and his wife was crying for him. Then suddenly something extraordinary happened.
My darling, you are the most generous man I have ever met. You deserve to be alive and continue your happy life. Now it is time to use my superpower. Let me confess. I am a mermaid, coming to Earth to help people. I used my magics before and I just have one more time and one magic left. After the last magic, I will turn into a mermaid again, and I have to go back to the ocean. Forever. I will miss you so much, my love. But, I need to save your life. Hello, darling. Welcome back to the life.
Oh. Wow. You changed. You look amazing. What has happened to us? Wow.
She told him about his brothers, their robbery, and also her story as a mermaid. She informed him she changed his brothers to two black dogs. To turn them into loyal creatures. He was surprised, for having two dogs as brothers. But he liked the idea, since he was sick of their problems. At least dogs are loyal to their owner and friends. But losing his wife, his best friend, his partner, was beyond his tolerance. He wished that she was never turned into this magnificent lady. He wanted his own wife back. And guess what? Whom? Amen Bird. Amen Bird was flying over their neighborhood.
I cannot survive without my wife. If she has to go, I prefer to be dead again.
Amen. The Amen Bird said, and the magic happened. They were back to their little store, working together again. Trying to forget the nightmare of two brothers and instead, enjoy having two black sweet puppies.
So this is me, Mr. Monster. A busy man who cannot leave the store, which we developed later into a mall, with my wife who is so busy too. Also the dogs need care.
Go human, just go. I enjoyed your story too. I love how you love your wife and how she loved you back. Wow. Such a love story.
I can't mess with a monster. When I first saw the merchant, I felt like he is my brother. The brother who I never had. I know I am much older than him. He can be my little sweet brother.
Whatever, human, whatever.
So may I have one third too? Please?
Oh. Whatever, human, like I said, whatever. I am so hungry and cannot wait for eating my one third of this yummy, merchant.
You are not surprised. Are you? Let me go back home and get ready for the next part of the story. I have finished the two first old men stories. Wait for the rest. Bye for now, Kuchaks.
Kodohalfes. Kodohalfes. Kuchak friends.